And thank you so much for joining me today. My name is Kathy Fillion, and today I am pressing replay on 14 of my favorite craft ideas that we've done over the years. I've got everything from some really fun ways to gift wrap, to how to make clothespin fairy dolls, to just some really fun, simple decor ideas that you can do. So get ready, we've got 14 different crafts to show you.
Altered dominoes are perfect for creating magnets, necklace pendants, and mini ornaments. Look for them at thrift shops or at yard sales. First, you'll need to paint your child's hand with folk art paints. Don't worry, they're non-toxic. Then you'll press onto paper and add Santa face details. Next, you'll need to photocopy that and cut out your handprint. We're going to use a glass plate, dishwasher safe Mod Podge, and some lime green tissue. Turn your plate over and make sure you've cleaned it with rubbing alcohol. Then just add your dishwasher safe Mod Podge right on the top of your handprint. Place it in the center of the plate, then smooth out the paper for any air bubbles, top coat with more Mod Podge, and now you're ready to add your lime green tissue. I used about 3 layers of this tissue paper to get the deep color. You'll just keep adding the layers, and once you have it filled in, let it dry for about an hour before you add the next coat. Voila! Make sure you check the bottle for all the cure times.
Use Mod Podge Extreme Glitter to make Epsom salt candles really sparkle. Paint your plaque with patina paint. Folk art multi-surface paint is non-toxic, so this is kid-friendly. Add glitter to the snow people by brushing on Mod Podge Extreme Glitter. Dab collage clay to make a snow drift. Sprinkle a little glitter over the snow.
Clothespin dolls are always a hit at holiday bazaars. They're very easy to make. You just need a base, a ball for the head, and a vintage style clothespin. We've pre-drilled some holes, and those will be for our arms. They're just pipe cleaners. Paint the head, and then decorate the clothespin in an outfit. You'll just glue the head to the top. I like to use Sparkle Mod Podge to add a soft, glittery look to the hair. Begin by cutting about 20 handprints of various sizes. For this project, we're using matte Mod Podge. Working on a painted palette, you want to start at the bottom with the largest handprints. Top coat with Mod Podge and allow to dry. Use nails and baker's twine to create a string art garland. Apply Sparkle Mod Podge to the tips of the fingers. Attach wood decorative elements.
Wall decor is always popular at holiday bazaars.
Use fabric Mod Podge to create a homespun look. It's perfect for gluing fabrics to fabrics. You can even use cutout letters with it. Follow this recipe to create a salt dough handprint. Position the hand so the fingers point down. Add some pink cheeks. Use collage clay to add texture. Add a touch of glitter with Sparkle Mod Podge. Add highlights with charcoal black and a detail paintbrush. Seal with satin Mod Podge. Use up your scrapbook paper to create these fun fringe trees. Make a confetti-topped box by applying Mod Podge liberally to the top and then just sprinkle confetti over it.
Joining me today. I hope that you had fun watching those 14 different craft ideas, and make sure that you hit subscribe and ring the bell if you want to get alerts, and I will see you next week with another video.